When I have my hair in a ponytail, I wear this shirt and these glasses. Does it make me look like Lester from Grand Theft Auto? The good people of Skull & Co. sent me one of these. This is a grip switch case thing for your Nintendo Switch, as well as your Nintendo Switch OLED. Not a lot of people are doing OLED products already, but Skull & Co. was already first to bat here, the first ones I've heard of anyway. Which, when you think about it, the reason to have the OLED is to play it in portable mode. If it's docked, it doesn't matter. So here's all these great products on the market that you can't even use, but Skull & Co. came out with something like this, and I'm excited to check it out. So excited, they even sent me a box that has some other products in it. We're going to check those out later on in this video, but I am very excited to see what this thing's all about. There's a couple of adapters, and this is gonna be important later on in this video. Nice, hard, sturdy case. I like that. You know, it's perfect because, I mean, you can use this as a carry-on, or you can just like slide it into your backpack and you're not gonna have to worry about it being, you know, banged up or anything like that. I think you'll be okay. If you were a kid of the 80s, maybe even the 90s, did you ever pretend the zipper was you scratching a record and make those like record scratching sounds? Hey, trust me, I still do. And oh, look at this. They even included a screen, one of those screen protector thingies. Very cool. And here's the grip itself. Very lightweight on this. I like that. Nice pearl white, which will look great if you have the pearl white OLED model. But again, it'll also work for your standard issue Switch. I'm gonna leave that mistake in there because I stumble and stutter all the time, so it's all good. Now, at the moment, I only have the standard issue Switch, so I'm going to test this out. So really, just pop it in. Ooh, come on. So with that little clip on top there, you just kind of pop it in and it just kind of snaps right in. It looks what it looks like. Oh, there you go. Yeah, that was easy enough. And that's the thing with me and Joy-Cons. Like when it's by itself, it's too thin. It's too narrow for my giant hands. I need something to grab onto it from the back. So when I have something like this and I can play like this, that's exactly what I'm looking for. And I guess this fits really well just for the standard issue Nintendo Switch. And I like how that has a little groove there. So you can either hold it like this if you're playing something, or if you need to use the buttons, you can also hold on to it like this and have it like this. Ah, I like this. Nice form fitting. And again, these little adapter things, these here on the back, they just slide right off, as there are other options that you can use to slide new ones in. I like that one too. That one's a little bit more rounded here. Doesn't have that place to hold onto it with your finger, but I could see that being a thing too, where you just grab onto it. I like that. Yeah, you see, it gives you some options. I like the fact that it gives you options like this. Ah, and here are the third set of options. These ones look interesting. These ones have these kind of like, you know, grippy design to them. So for instance, I want to have one on one side, and then I want to have that more flatter grippy one on this side. So this one I'm holding on to for the analog, and this one, ooh, I could see that being a thing. You know, just like, you know, again, it's however you want to use it. I could see you mixing and matching them in two. It is whatever fits your form the best. And I think I like both sides with that little finger holder. Snaps into place. Love it. Little grip thingies, depending on what you're playing. Maybe, you know, a racing game might play differently than an RPG. You put those right there, put those there. Here you have a couple of ideas. Here's your, you know, you can just protect it there. Game cases here. That's where you can put your games. Another little cords and whatnot up here. Headphones, you know, power cord, your USB-C perhaps. And one of the features of this travel case that I don't think I've seen anywhere else is the travel case itself. And this is super important if you've been on flights, you're trying to watch the in-flight movie with your phone, you have nowhere to put it really. With this, if you're playing, it has these little grooves on the inside. Oh, come on. I don't know if you can see those little grooves there, but those grooves are exactly for just that. So you can actually kind of like prop it up. Actually props up in a way, so it makes it so you can, you know, kind of view your Switch that way if you'd like. It's kind of fun. Whether it's OLED or standard Switch, case right here, it's gonna fit both of them. And you can see it right there, those little three screws there, you can undo those and that'll make it so it'll fit your OLED. So here's your three screws part, and it gives you two options there. Now I can kind of snap the tabs to make it fit more proper. So that little plastic thing just comes off like that. And then if it's, you know, if it's this side, then that's for your standard Switch, and then your OLED, a little bit slimmer on that one. So that's gonna fit better. That's so cool that it gives you the option. You know, my hands, I have big hands, starting to get arthritis a little bit. I'm that age, man, I'm old. You know, it's gonna be a more comfortable experience for me all the same. But in the meantime, standard style, super quick and easy to slap on there. There, it's done, just like that. Pop it in the case, good. Now let me set this aside just for now. I'm gonna put this back in the case because I'm curious to see what else they sent. I was just looking at the instructions. I was supposed to remove one of the Joy-Cons and then slide it in there and then slide it back into place. But no, I just popped it right in. I just popped it in. It's fine. This is cool. This is a plate for... Is this for the... This is for the dock. I can tell because there's that little the light side thingy right there. So very, very cool. If you want to go through the process, it involves unscrewing this part, keeping the dock as it is, pulling the ribbon out, and you get to the side that has the screws. You can remove this part and put that right here. So that's what your Nintendo Switch dock would look like, which is super, super cool. I'm not gonna do it in this video, but they have the option that you can get something like this, which I think is, that's super cool. Like, come on, that's awesome. Replacement analog thingies? Let's find out. Oh, it's exactly what they are. That's awesome, okay. And they're not just replacements, but they are better, as they may give you an extra bit of control or just ability or just feel for what this little Joy-Con does. I mean, these things here, really, you can just take them off. You just peel them right off. They came with six, and two of them are basically just your common replacements. And then these two, one of them is a little divot, and then the other one has a little bit of a height to it. Kind of hard to tell, but I want to try one here. So maybe you weren't supposed to just remove it. It's all right, they're easy to put back on. So like that, that one gives a little bit more height, which I kind of like. Feel like I might have a little bit more control, especially for some of the flight games and stuff like that. It was one of my complaints about the Joy-Con. It's almost like, it reminded me of like the PSP Joy-Con, like, or the PSP analog. It's like, yeah, it works, it's functional, but man, it's super short. I feel like I need a little bit more control, and something like that, one that gives a little bit more height. I think I'm okay with that. Now let me put this one back on, because I shouldn't have taken it off in the first place. Like I said, it wasn't so hard. Okay, now here's the one with the divot, which I'm also very curious about. That just kind of slips right on there. Oh, that was super easy. Yeah. Oh, it's still picking out a little bit. Hold on. Let me arrange it just a little bit more. There we go. Perfect. Yeah. So, I don't know which one I like more. I think I like the one with the divot more. So now that's what that one looks like now. It has a little bit of a thumbprint, if you will. Unlike that one, which doesn't, but that one has a little bit more height to it. So I feel like I have a little bit more control. Fun. So again, just whatever your preference is. Cool Skull & Co. making cool stuff. Oh, of course. Gotta have this, right? I wonder what this is for. Can you tell? Is that all this is? Oh man. See, I've seen so many of these where it's like, man, I don't want to put all that together. I don't want to put all that together because there's so much going on. You know, there's like, you know, the unscrew things, screw things back in. I've seen way too many YouTube videos of people trying to do a custom case mod, you know, to get their Switch looking completely awesome and having it fail and like, you know, accidentally like hurting their Switch and all that. And by the time it took you to tell the end of that story, it's already done. I mean, I've seen videos where people just kind of, you know, they fry their system. And by the time it took me that story, it's already off. If you want just a quick custom Switch dealio to give you that awesome look, and it's still accessible to your cards, your USB, all that, that's the way to go. Oh, and they included the Joy-Cons part too. Hold on. Oh, it includes a little grippy thingy there. The Joy-Cons don't have that. So this will just slide right over it, right? Oh, here, maybe I should take it out. And let me drop that on the ground for a second here. Okay, so a little bit of that. And this part can even slide over it. Hold on, that's the wrong side. This is what we should have had in the first place. Yeah, it's nice to have all, you know, like unscrew it, screw it back in, have it be perfect fit. But dude, this has this part too. And that just kind of locks into place too, huh? Yeah, there you go. That's all it is. Yeah, never mind messing with a screwdriver. That's the way to go. You just pop it right on in. Slides right into place. Perfect fit. There it is. No screws needed. No screws, no undoing screwdrivers, no keeping things careful. It's already done. And because these things are here at the very, very bottom, which the Joy-Cons don't have, it even feels better just like this. Now, because it is on top of things, the buttons are a little bit sunken. They are a little bit sunken. They feel like, what's the game system I'm thinking of that has these kind of sunken buttons here? They still work. I mean, it's still accessible. And it might be a little bit more sunken than you'd like it to be. I just love how it looks, though. No screwdrivers or anything. I love that about this. Awesome. Now, this will not fit in this. Keep that in mind. D-pad button caps for your Joy-Cons. Hey, there's the thing I needed. Again, a couple of other options, too. You don't need to use them all. You just use whatever one fits you best, you know? I'll just leave that top part off. So this, I mean, I don't need to tell you what that is. That's a D-pad. And although your left Joy-Con should have included a D-pad, it included these stickers. And there are self-adhesive stickers, so you stick it on there, peel the thing off, put those on there. So then when you stick it on there, now you have a D-pad for your Switch. In doing that, I won't have that cool little case over it, but you know what? That's going to be okay. I'm going to use this anyway. So it says just kind of stick it on there and then peel this part off. Oh, I see that there is a sticker on there that includes this little black foam pad as well. And that's where you put the middle of the D-pad, that kind of rounded style D-pad too. Interesting. So whatever one you're feeling. I'll stick with traditional D-pad. Good to have the Good to know there's an option though.
I gotta go crazy eyes just to unpeel this thing. That looks like it's supposed to come off, but it's also...
When I peel the paper back, it's also removing that part of the sticker that I want to keep on there. It feels so good to have a D-pad right there.
There we go. Here, I'll just try this. So stick there.
Oh, it worked. Perfect. Okay, let's do it that way.
Yeah, because I'm trying to like stick these on there according to instructions, and it's not sticking the way I want it to. So I'm gonna do this. I'll stick it to myself. I'll just kind of scrape at it with my other fingernail. What's left of it anyway.
I have two stickers on there, one on the top, one on bottom. I have that little foam pad in the middle. There it is. Got it. Okay,
so I can't just leave it alone. I gotta see what the buttons look like too. So I'm gonna do that right now too. Got yellow as B, that's at the bottom.
There it is. Got the D-pad over on this side as needed. Feels nice and it feels pretty good. I'm looking forward to using it. I know the buttons are being pressed. I gotta actually use it though. And then these buttons feel really good. And I don't think these buttons are going anywhere either, so. And that's all they had for the Nintendo Switch, but they left one more thing for the PlayStation of all things. And what that is, I'm not gonna install it in this video. You can actually install LEDs into your PlayStation 5 to give it that kind of rainbow look. How awesome is that? Everything you saw in this video came from skullandco.com. Make sure you check out the link in the description below. And again, thank you to them for providing me these fun things for this video. I didn't know what to expect, and I was pleasantly surprised on the options that are out there, especially things for your Switch OLED. More Switch videos coming in the future. We'll see you soon.